guys, here's the new video. I'm trying something kind of complicated. This is for live, well, almost really live, from the New York Comic Con, or at least closer I can get to it. But I got this little two-pack there. Now, this is the Bumblebee and RC Transformers Prime first edition at the top, which I would tilt, but they would all fall out because they've all been undone already. The two-pack for the New York Comic Con. I almost didn't get it, but I figured I'm at the conventions, my first time at a convention, where they not only had an exclusive relevant to my interests, so I thought I would check it out. The big selling point for me on this set is, you know, all this stuff's nice, but I really do like this display inside. When I get back home, I'm going to toss everything in the packaging except for the inserts. You have this nice little street in the background. You have NY and the Autobot logo on the buildings. They are, like, three-dimensional, like, cardboard. And if you look in the back, there's Megatron and Starscream just hanging out. And then there's a Statue of Liberty over there. I mean, it's a nice little diorama piece. And I really do like it. I think that's a really good selling point. I can see someone wanting to keep this mint in packaging because it just looks good. Of course, you do have Raph and Jack inside, which, you know, minifigures, they're okay. But let's open it up. And there's RC. There's Bumblebee. There's Jack. And there's Raph. And now, I'm hoping you can see some of this. I know I don't have really good quality. My lighting's all off. I don't have any lighting, but this little rinky-dink little lamp here, which I can rotate. That's something. But here are the figures, and that looks a little too bright. RC is, of course, a bit bigger than she should be, but that's how it's going to be for a bike. The minifigures aren't really that bad. It is interesting to note that while they do have little display bases, you can pull those off and display them on their own. They are a bit wobbly, Jack especially, but they just peg right in, and there you go. Both of them have little Autobot logos and Y on them, so that's neat. Their heads can rotate, and that's really it. His little base does come off too. And if you've heard of the homies, the little minifigures, this reminds me of a homie figure a lot. And I'm tempted to find some of mine and compare them because he's really similar. Of course, the head can rotate. Likeness-wise, they're not bad. Like, they're really close to their animation counterparts. And, you know, they're okay. They just kind of stand there. That's it. I guess I'll do Bumblebee first. I do like him a bit more. He is in this taxicab kind of deco, and I think it works really nicely. It's a really nice car mode. I'm surprised, and his gun fell off. I just realized his gun falls off very easily. In fact, if you open yours and he's missing a gun, check in the box, it falls out. It just pegs in with these little tabs here. It's very loose, and if you push hard, if you will, undo his feet. But it doesn't hold securely. I mean, it's going to fall off extremely easy. So I put it aside for now. But a nice little car mode. Rolls really well. And I like it. I really do like it. I don't know if I'll get the actual official release, but I do like this. So to transform it, you're going to start by undoing the back portion here. And then when you undo it, there are two little tabs inside that you have to work out. And there's that. Let's go here. Undo the same thing. And that freezes the legs up. Now, take these and rotate them, and then go ahead and tuck that back. So repeat with this side, tuck that back, there's that. Take his little toesies out, and he can stand, kind of. You have to get him kind of balanced, and his legs are kind of crooked, so it's my fault. But there you go. Yay. Now this is a lot of mess. He is a level 2 out of 3 on their new transforming scale. I can see why. Gonna start undo this top part up here, and then you can bring the doors out. They are pegged in with these little bits here, just kind of loosen those up, leave them out there, and just get the doors out of the way. Now go to the front, and so you're gonna take this piece, fold it down for now, and I think you can actually start folding this down, but maybe not. You can get that down there, and then you need to undo a lot of this stuff. There are two little tabs inside there, so you have to undo this and then bring the head up like that. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff going on in there. And those just kind of spread out a little bit like that. Take the head, rotate that around, and then rotate the grill back around, and that's gonna slide back down. It does tend to get caught on these two little top bits, but just kind of work it in, and have it where the grill goes behind this piece here. And it should be about like that, so just get it lined up where everything just kind of fits. Roughly like that. Now from there, these two little gray tabs are going to fit inside little slots inside the rest of the hood. So just get that lined up, and you may be able to see, you may not. It's very, very small in there. There's not a whole lot of room. So if you cannot, I apologize. And there's that. Now, I have seen pictures where this is left unclipped and just kind of hanging off the side. And I can understand that, so you can see more of the Autobot logo. But the animation model has this gap filled in with these two little bits. So that's how I'm going to have it. It's basically up to you, really. I think it's more personal preference than set in stone. You do have to kind of fiddle around with this chest a little bit. Because this little piece, it bends at awkward angles. So you may have to kind of fiddle around with it and figure out what works best for you. There we go. The key, I think, is to get the front of the car straight when he's standing up. So, close enough. Now onto the rest of them. The arms, just kind of flip them down like that. Flip that down. Doors are going to be there. Fold those panels down. Fold the windshield down. And then you're going to swing the arms out like that. When you do it, it pops this little flap. So the arms are out. And then these are going to fold up, and that little peg is going to go into the middle of the wheel. And you have to give a really good squeeze, and then fold that around. And there's his arm. I mean, I like it. I really do. I'm not a huge fan of his animation model in the show, but it definitely was one of the harder ones to grow used to. But I like this guy. I think he's really neat. Like, he's grown on me significantly. And when that's done, you can take this little weapon, and it can mount in either arm. Both arms have a little little hole for it to peg into. And that pegs right in there, and it's a really tight fit. Really tight fit. But there you go. There's Mr. B and all of his glory falling over. And I like it. I mean, the doors, you can leave them kind of out a little more, tuck them in a little bit. You can even kind of fold them back. I mean, there's not much to really do with them that I can see, but I like him. I mean, I really do. I didn't think I would. I thought I would really dislike it. Articulation-wise, at the feet, for his transformation, it kind of leaves him with a little kind of added movement here, if you really want to call it that. The toes can bend, again, from his transformation, but you can't really do much there. I kind of wonder if that's supposed to tab in, because there's a little clip there, but maybe not. I don't know. Yoda's knee, the knee can bend, and he can rotate. He has a ball joint at the top, so this can move a little bit. There's also a cut joint here, so we can rotate below the hip or the thigh. And the leg, of course, can swing all the way around. Like, really good movement for the legs. The waist can rotate. Depending on how you have this could kind of move as a kind of an added joint. I mean, you could call that a joint. You really could, I think. You go to his head. It can look up and down, and look at left and right. It's on a ball, nice little ball joint. You know, he does have light piping, but it's very, very hard to get anything clear out of it. There is a nice section on the back. It's just it doesn't shine through very brightly, and that kind of stinks. The arms, when they're even though they're swinging out this kind of weird angle, they can still rotate pretty well. They do get caught on his shoulder and all that stuff, but they can swing out. Due to this transformation, they can kind of swing back in a mock way, although it's kind of weird. You can see that. I mean, it's, you know, it's there, but it's not really meant to be a articulation gimmick kind of thing. Ball joint for the elbow, so it can bend, it can rotate, all that stuff there, and his wrist can actually bend in and out. Which is interesting. And yeah, I like him. I mean, again, I'm not sure if I'll get the actual regular release when it comes out, but if you do have this 2-pack, you will be delighted with this figure. I do like him, and I think he looks pretty cool. He's kind of gorilla-like, his overall stance, but I like it. So there he is. He's probably going to fall over at some point. Now, RC was the hardest to get used to. This is RC in a G1 paint job. Not bad. I like her a lot more without these on there, her little blade weapons. A lot more of a streamlined bike. The kickstand can go up and down. It's a nice little bike mode. Now to transform it, you're going to take the legs and undo them first from these little tabs there. And then swing the legs out and back like that. and you can see where she gets a lot of her length from. You're gonna take the legs and just pull them until you can separate this back tire. And that first transformation, it's clicked in there very tightly. It's not as bad anymore, but there's that. Yeah. Go around here, and this is gonna flip up around like so. And you gotta push really hard to get her feet unlocked. But when you do, you get them down like that to give her these little heels. And when that's done, take this, kind of fold it. I'll do it from this angle so maybe we'll see a little better. Kind of fold it down a little bit so this is even with her heel. And then there's a little kind of a tab, that little pink piece right there, tabs into the wheel somewhat and completes her foot. So that's how it looks. And that back piece is basically her heel, helped her stand up. Repeat with this side, get it folded down. And then tab the wheel in place. It's not like locked in very well, but it's enough that just to display her, it does hold a pose and it does work. Go around to a top portion, rotate this around. There's her front. Take these and undo them. Swing her arms out. I think I said swing, but you need to swing her arms out. There's that. Rotate those around so her hands are facing the right direction. And that. Get those all straightened up. And this is the last part. You're going to take this top portion, fold this down some, fold the seat back all the way, reach inside, pull out her little noggin. And that's going to fold back up and fit over like that. And then take the wheel. Now, the instructions said to, I believe, have it like that. Personally, I like having it more like that. I think it fits a little better. But you're going to take the front. It's already separated on mine, but you're going to split that up. And these are going to swing around to the front to help kind of fill out her chest. They don't peg in place at all, which is a bummer. I wish they would have locked in place at some degree, but I don't see where they could. They just kind of rest there. And this last little bit, you're going to rotate the windshield around, flip the handlebars in about halfway. If you do it all the way, it gets stuck about like that. Flip them at least about that much, and they fit in that little groove. And there's RC. Like, transmission's kind of complicated at first, but once you get the hang of it, it's surprisingly easy. And yeah, I do wish these would tab in a little bit better. That one actually fits in really well, so why don't you? Maybe I had the wrong one. Ooh, there we go. Okay, you gotta pinch this bottom portion. Once you do that, it helps lock it in place. But yeah, there's RC. I do like her. Her light piping, I don't have any kind of flashlight to show her off her light piping, I'm sorry. But it is rather nice. Her face sculpt looks pretty cool. These, I wish, would lock in somehow. They just kind of rest and they pop open and she can flash you. But I like her. She's pretty nifty. Put that up a little bit. Hope it doesn't fall over. This pink is really, really G1 kind of accurate. It's really pale. It's not like a flashy neon pink or anything. Someone asked if she would work in like a classics collection. Maybe. Like, she does have that animated look. She does. Or the prime look. But she could fit in your classics collection, possibly. She does have a kind of a G1 based body type once you get her transformed. And I do like her. You can kind of get her, you know, giving you some faff. I don't know. No idea what I'm doing anymore. Now, you can, of course, take these to give her these little bladed weapons on her arm. I really don't like these, and I think if they had left them out entirely from the vehicle mode and the robot mode, she would look even better. These just do nothing for me. They make her robot mode look a lot less sleek and a lot more just kibbly, and I'm just not a fan of it, really. So without it, I think she looks a whole lot better, but you can see how she looks there. Like I said, personally, I leave them off. Articulation-wise of the head, rotates, looks up and down. Really nice. There's an added hinge joint down there, so not only does she have the ball joint for her neck, you can even kind of move that around, primarily for her transformation. The arms can swing out. They're on ball joints, and they rotate, so there's all of that. The elbow has a double elbow joint, so you can get bent there and bent up there. The wrist is on a hinge, so we can move around. The waist can rotate. The legs can go forward and back really nice and far. And so they can swing out. And they can even rotate. Isn't that special? They can rotate. The knees can bend pretty far. Her ankles are stationary. There's no movement for her feet because everything is really locked in there. But overall, I like her. I really do. I think I would like the actual blue release a lot more than the pink one. But as it is, I like her. And I'm kind of tempted to put her in the Classics collection. Maybe. I don't know. But there they are together. I don't know if I'm missing a way to make him taller. I don't think I am. But he is kind of short compared to RC. So there's that. This was, I think, $30, maybe $33 at the Hasbro Toy Shop booth. This is going to be on sale at HasbroToyShop.com, I believe, Monday, if not very shortly after. I would say pick it up. If you are a fan of Transformers Prime, this is a nice little exclusive to have, and I think it does look pretty cool. The actual Prime toys aren't coming out until, I think, December, so this could tide you over until then, especially if you have the first edition Optimus that came out for Comic-Con in San Diego. I would say check it out. But yeah, I like them. So there you go. Thanks for watching, and take care.